Hello, today we are going to discuss the output devices. A computer is a device which accepts input in the form of binary data, processes the input data by applying a series of well-defined computations to produce the desirable results. However, it is difficult for the human beings to provide the input data to the computer or easily interpret output in the form of binary data. In order to bridge this gap, input and output devices were invented, and today we are going to discuss the various types of output devices. These output devices are used for effective interactions of the human beings with the computer. The input devices take the data from the user and supply the data to the computer in the binary form. Similarly, the output devices convert the binary data and provide the data to the user in the form of readable text or presentable form. In this session, we are going to study various types of output devices. The output devices are the devices which are used to convert the binary information generated by the computer into readable text or presentable form, as explained earlier. Some of the output devices are visual display unit, that is a monitor, printer, graphic output devices, plotters, speakers. A new type of output devices is also being developed these days, known as the speech synthesizer. A speech synthesizer is a mechanism attached to the computer which produces verbal output sound almost like the human speeches. The output devices can be classified into three different types that are available, and those are display devices, printing devices, and audio output devices. As I explained, one of the output devices in the audio output category is speech synthesizer. The display devices are the devices using which the output generated by the computer can be shown to the user on a computer screen. For example, computer screen, monitor is an example of display device, which are shown on the types of the output which are shown on the output devices, like monitor or screen are text, graphics, and video. The text consists of characters, letters, numbers, punctuation marks, or any other symbol requiring 1 byte of computer storage that are used to create words, sentences, paragraphs. The graphics are the digital representation of non-text information such as drawings, charts, photographs, animations. A series of still images in a rapid sequence that gives the illusion of the motion, and therefore it is called a video or animation. Video consists of images played back at speeds to provide the appearance of a full motion like a movie. Another type of output device is a printing device. Printing is defined as refers to the information that has been recorded on a tangible medium, the things that you can touch, such as paper or a microfilm. In short, printing produces a permanent copy of display image generated on an output device such as printer or plotter. Hard copy of any information or data or documents can only be generated if it's soft copy, or else its material is available in the soft form in the computer. That means, in order to take the printout from through a printer, first you need to store the information in the soft form inside the hard disk, and then only you can take the printout. In brief, to generate a printout, the user should first produce a soft copy of that content. The printers can be classified by the printing technology they employ. There are a number of printing technologies available which are used in the commercial products as per the printing needs of the user. The choice of the print technology decides the cost of the printer, cost of operation, speed, quality, and the performance of the documents, and also the noise produced by the printer during its operation. Some printer technologies don't work with certain types of physical media such as plastic, paper, or other mediums. A second aspect of printer technology is its resistance to alteration. The liquid coming out of an inkjet head or fabric ribbon becomes absorbed by the paper fiber, so that the documents printed with liquid ink are more difficult to alter than the documents printed with toner or solid inks, as they do not penetrate below the medium surface, that is the paper surface. The ticket received given by the bus conductor or the ATM received have limited lifetime, because the ink is not absorbed by the paper, and therefore after few months the written portion is wiped out. At the same time, the printout from a dot matrix printer or a lawn printer, if protected from humidity, survives for years without any change. Therefore, the decision to buy a printer also depends upon how long you need to preserve the printed paper. Most desktop PCs are connected to a printer. As mentioned earlier, the printers offer a number of important aspects such as technology use, size, speed, and quality. In general, the printers are classified as, one classification is impact versus non-impact printer, another classification is color versus black and white printer, third classification is personal versus network printer, fourth classification is laser printer versus inkjet printer, another classification is the special purpose printers used in photo printers, barcode printers, label printers, sticker printers, portable printers, plotters, and multifunction printing devices are the different types of printers which are available in the market. In the first classification of impact versus non-impact printer, as I discussed, the impact printing uses a print mechanism that strikes the paper to transfer ink on the paper. For example, a dot matrix printer uses a print head consisting of pins that strike an ink ribbon to transfer ink to the paper. It is appropriate selective forward movement of the pins combined with the movement of the print head in forward direction forms the letters, words, and subsequently sentences. The same can be used to print images of low resolution. A dot matrix printer cannot print images of high resolution because of the limited resolution of dots which are printed using a dot matrix printer. The impact printers are used for printing receipts, packing slips, and various other applications where low cost printing is needed. However, most printers used today for personal and commercial applications are non-impact printers. That means they form images without the print mechanism actually touching the paper. Laser and inkjet printers are non-impact printers. The quality of image produced by these printers is better than the impact printers and generate minimum noise when under operation. Both these printers form images with dots, similar to the way monitor display images with pixels. The next, the printers are classified after, say, I have explained impact and non-impact printers. The next classification, as told earlier, was color versus black and white printers. The colored printers use at least four colors of ink, cyan, magenta, yellow, and black, instead of only black inks used in the black and white printers. The color printers either apply all the colors in one pass, or multiple passes of printing are required where each color is selected for printing in every pass. The color printing is used at homes for printing photographs, greeting cards, and preparing advertisements. The black and white printers are used for business applications like printing receipts, invoices, and bills, since it is less expensive. The another classification, as told earlier, is personal versus network printers. The printers attached to a single desktop are called personal printers, because only a single person that printer is used by only a single person, and it is connected through a single desktop. Whereas the network printer is a shared device. A network printer can be shared across multiple desktops over a network. The network printer can receive simultaneous requests for printing from multiple desktops and handles the requests one by one coming from the multiple desktops. That means if in a company there are 50 users using 50 desktops, all of the 50 users can share a single network printer. All of the 50 desktops can fire their printing request to the network printer, and then they can collect their printout from the network printer. Generally, these network printers, not only they are shared, but also they are high speed and are designed for bulk printing. The printers are also classified on the basis of their resolution, which is measured in the form of dots per inches. The number of dots per inch determine the quality of the printed output. Generally, 300 dpi is used for general purpose printing. The 600 dpi is used for high quality documents. The 1200 dpi is used for photographs, and 2400 dpi, that means the dots per inch, that means 24 dpi is considered to be a very high resolution printing and is used for professional applications like advertisement, animations. The print speed of the dot matrix printer is typically measured in characters per second, that is CPS, and the speed of the line printers is measured in the form of lines per minute. The speed of the non-impact printer like laser printers is measured in pages per minute. However, the print speed varies and depends upon the type of print output. The color printing is slower than black and white. Of the same specification, you have the print specification says that it can print 20 pages in a minute, but color printing will be a bit slower as compared to black and white printing. The photographs take longer to print than the text print. Laser printers use laser technology for printing. The laser is used to charge the appropriate locations on the drum to form the pages image, and the toner is powder is released from the toner cartridge and sticks to the drum. A heating unit fuses the toner powder to the paper from the drum when the paper is rolled over the drum. The laser printer prints one page at a time and are faster than the inkjet printers. The common print resolutions of the laser printer vary from 600 dpi to 2400 dpi, and the speed varies from 15 pages per minute to 25 pages per minute. The inkjet printers, which is another form of non-impact printers, form images by dropping or spraying tiny drops of the liquid ink onto the page, one printed line at a time. Some inkjets have different size nozzles to drop liquid ink in various sizes, and some have electric mechanism to control the size of droplet coming out of the nozzle. The inkjet printer prints colors of various types by pre-mixing four colors of ink, as explained earlier. These four colors are magenta, cyan, yellow, and black. These colors are packed in different cartridge chambers. The size of the nozzle is close to the size of the human hair. With this, I have explained so far the mechanism of laser printer and the inkjet printer. The next in the series of general special purpose printers are, which are used for printing photographs, barcodes, bank passbooks, sticker, and label printing. The photo printers, which are used for printing photographs, are increasing or gaining lot of popularity these days as digital cameras are commonly used. The photo printers are attached to the desktop to print photo stored in the hard drive or a flash drive. Also, the photo can be directly printed by attaching a digital camera to it. The photo printers have a preview screen which allow you to see the photograph under print. If the photograph or the print quality is not satisfactory, minor editing and correction can be done to remove spots on the face, minimize wrinkles if any. You can print photographs of various sizes with the photo printer. Some printers like snapshot printers have built-in camera and print photographs of size 4 inch by 6 inches and are used normally by the shopkeepers. Photo printers use either inkjet technology or thermal transfer technology. This thermal transfer technology is used to print on the special glossy paper, and this special glossy paper combined with the thermal print technology gives a superior quality to the photograph. But the cost of printing per page of this glossy paper is higher. The another type of printer which is used for the special purpose applications is the barcode printer. The barcode printers are used for printing barcodes. These barcodes are commonly used in supermarkets, shops for pasting on items so that a barcode reader can easily identify that item. A barcode is nothing but a sequence of lines printed with varying distances, and this special sequence of lines indicate a code, and this special device barcode reader can read that code and pass on that code to the computer. Similarly, you need a device to print the barcode, and that barcode slip is pasted on most of the items which are sold in the supermarket. Another classification of printing is the label printing. Label printers are used for printing special labels for envelopes, file folders. Sometimes these labels are available as stickers on the special paper and can be sticked on the plastic or metal surface also. These printers are also called asset management printers and are called sticker printers. The another type of printers which are commonly used in buses to issue tickets are called portable printers. The portable printers is not just a printer, but it is a device where the bus conductor can select the ticket, can define the route, and accordingly it can instruct the portable printer to print the ticket for the route desired by the user, and accordingly he can charge the user as per the route selected by the user. These printers are lighter in weight and can be customized for various applications where receipt printing is required. Because the same lightweight printers which is used by a bus conductor for printing the ticket receipt can have variety of applications. It can be used for check-in in a railway system. It can be used for check-in in any corporate or any office. Whenever you go to the office, it can be used for the purpose of issuing a pass so that you can enter the office. Another device, another important printing device is a plotter. A plotter is an output device and used most often for creating graphics such as charts, drawings, maps, blueprints, and three-dimensional illustrations. It can produce specialized and free from drawings on the medium in the form of two-dimensional graphic representation. The plotters are used to produce large drawings and images, including color posters, signs, and advertising banners. These plotters use inkjet technology for printing and primarily used to print on paper. However, the variants of these printers can be used for printing on fabric and other type of materials like metal and plastic. The another classification of the printers is the multifunction printers, which are very popular these days. The multifunction printer, over and above the routine printing, can also be used for scanning documents. It can also be used for producing another copy of the document like Xerox. It can also be used for sending a fax, and therefore, when the multiple functions are combined in a printer like scanning, Xeroxing, that means photocopying, fax, and printing, these printers are called multifunction devices, or also called all-in-one printers. These printers are very popular these days as they save costs, time, space, and most importantly, perform a variety of jobs of an individual. Most multifunction printers include printing, scanning, fax, and copying among their many features. Many printers are local print peripherals connected directly to a nearby personal computer, but the commercial printers are networked and shared across multiple desktops and users. These printers are heavy duty and faster. Another type of output device is the output generated through the audio. The audio output is output in the form of voice or music. Speakers and headsets are the most common types of audio output hardware. The speakers connect to the PC and provide audio output. The most common applications are playing computer games, producing sound output, listening music, and video. The another application is video conferencing, where using a monitor, you can not only talk remotely, but also see the face of the person on the other side of the conferencing. The audio output is also used in speech output systems, which can be used to read screen text to the computer users. A special software programs called screen readers attempt to identify and interpret what is being displayed on the screen, and the speech synthesizers convert the data to vocalized sounds or text. These kinds of output devices are very beneficial to different sections of the society, for example, for illiterates or for blinds. Also, the text reading combined with the audio leads to better grasping for an average student. Even many kinds of softwares are also available on the market, which tends to perform same kind of job, but they also use the speaker as the medium of output. These devices help them in identifying and doing the work more efficiently and helps in curbing their disability. Some of the audio output devices are speakers, which come in different configuration depending upon the user demands and the need. Speech synthesizers, headphones, earphones, etc. Some speakers consist of only pair of speakers. Others include a subwoofer for better bass tones. Many speakers have a headphone, which allows a headphone to be used so that sound does not disturb others. These days, desktops, laptops, mobiles have speakers and headphone jacks integrated into the device. Also, the provision for external speakers is there to boost sound quality and produce other effects. So, to summarize, what we have learned today are the various types of output devices like display, printer, and audio. The display devices will be discussed in detail in other modules later. The printer and audio devices are discussed in detail. The printers produce hard copy output through either impact or non-impact technology. If the printer strikes the paper for printing, it is called impact printer. Otherwise, if the printer does not strike the paper for printing, it is non-impact. As we have seen, the images are formed by printing using matrix of dots, which are too small to be visible. The quality of printing is measured in dots per inch. The speed is measured in pages per minute. The printer can be connected to a single desktop or may be shared by number of desktop over a network, also called a network printer. The printing can be in color as well as black and white. The most common printers are dot matrix printer, line printer, laser printer, inkjet printer, which we have studied. The special purpose printers are used for special purpose applications like printing photographs. We have photo printers, printing barcodes for pasting on the items on a supermarket. You have barcode printers. For portable printing, you have lightweight printers available, which are generally used by the bus conductors in a bus and various other applications. The plotters are used for special purpose printing like graphics, animations, and drawings, charts, and wide format inkjet printers are used again for the similar purpose. The multifunction printers, as we have studied earlier, have added functionality of scan, copy, and fax over and above the printing capability for the purpose of saving cost and space. Because instead of asking the user to buy a separate fax machine, a separate scanner, a separate photocopy, a separate printer, a multifunction printer has all these capabilities in one device, and therefore, as explained earlier, it is also called a all-in-one device. It saves cost and space. We also learned audio output devices, which include speakers to the output music, video or spoken voice. These audio devices enable computer systems to play spoken messages from digital stored words and sounds. The headphones are used to direct the output of the speaker directly to the ears without disturbing anybody else sitting nearby. So, with this, I conclude my explanation about the output devices. Thank you.